So let me come to the specific proposal that I have in, by way of opening the conversation. I think that it would be, first of all, I obviously want to commend the work that's been done here. I think that it's fantastic. But I think that in order for that to really be significant, it has to come, to go out of the walls of the university. It has to engage the public. There has been references here to Conyers HR 40, and the, what is it now, 16 years that he's been presenting it year in, year out? HR 40, as you all well know, calls for a study and for a commission to work on it. And I think that we have to recognize that the government is more the problem than the solution, and that Congress is not the one where that should emanate from, but rather this is probably the place where that should come from. I think that I would like to propose to the committee that the recommendations would include the establishment of a most eminent person's national commission that will engage several major universities, or at least leaders from those universities, would be funded by major foundations, and would be a commission for slavery, justice, and reconciliation, and would do what Clinton's commission on race never did, get public attention, make the conversation available to the, to people, make it a part of a national conversation of educational effort, and really capture the attention of people. You, some of you are familiar with Myrdal's American Dilemma and with the importance that it had in terms of engaging a whole class of intellectuals and professionals in what led later to Brown and other civil rights movement, etc. I think that such a commission can make a huge difference. This is something that we're trying to do, for instance, in Uganda on a different question, precisely the kind of things that have been described here in other forms, including people-to-people speech, bringing communities together, engaging scholars and peoples, of discussing the ethnic animosity in a way that opens it and presents different perspectives from both sides. And I think the lesson that we got today about the Brown family earlier is an immensely instructive one in terms of, if that is not being given to the few tens of us here, but rather becomes with subtlety. There was not hitting anybody on the head with anything. This was presenting the information very dry, empirical, that is very moving. And I think this is the purpose of much of us. The animosity of whether it is the guilt of that or the guilt of others create alienation. And if people want to create binary divisions, that creates alienation. I think the focus has to be on reconciliation, but it has to be national conversation. And I propose that. Thank you very much.